recently on Gladden TV.
Everybody love a good story. I had nothing. I came over here with nothing. All I had was a beach towel and a pencil. We all love that shit, but it don't go down like that, man. Not in 2022. You gotta work hard, especially if you got no college degree, especially if you got no career job. You gotta work hard. You gotta find yourself, you'll find yourself, you know, having 2 to 3 jobs.
I'm gonna take my horse through the old town road. I'm gonna ride till I can't no more.
I got the horses in the back, horse stock is attached. Head is matted black, got the bushes black to match. Riding on a horse, ha, you can whip your Porsche. I've been in the valley, you ain't been up off that porch. Now, can't nobody tell me nothing.
That look like the Al Bundy shit, right? Da-da-da-da-da. What's going on with y'all, man? Back at it again. Another day, another dollar. Another day in the life of Gladden TV. So, I'm just chilling, man. But I'm gonna get back to y'all. I'm not going in there. I'm gonna chill right here.
I missed a week last week, man. I miss weeks in this thing because, just like everybody else, I'm human. And sometimes I just don't got the time to record myself, you know? It's like I'm fighting against the sun. But I think there's a soccer game going on right now. But, yeah, I just been buying my cryptos, you know, buying my DigiByte, buying some Bitcoin, buying my red coin. I actually met my red coin goal. And, I'm not gonna say I'm gonna lock that away because I hate people that say, hey, I'm gonna just buy that and lock that away. I'm gonna keep my eye on that shit. But nothing has changed for me as far as the mission, you know? Been buying my little $26 worth of DigiByte, my little $25 worth of Bitcoin, stacking those Satoshis. I said it before, but I say it again. You don't have to, but you want to have at least 1 million Satoshis. You know what I'm saying? So you can just have, for the sake of having them. And, yeah. But enough of that. Y'all know me. I gotta be extra. I like to talk about things that, you know, that aren't really crypto related, but they're all relative. So I want to say this. I want to say... Manifest destiny seems to be losing. Manifest destiny seems to be losing the battle. I say that because territory is the main focus, right? It seems like the United States of America is anti-crypto, right? Every time you look around, it's New York this or Florida that, or California, and so on, Wyoming. Everybody seems to be on board, but the government, you see, they seem to be totally against it. I know the whole XRP, Ripple case thing is supposed to determine the entire crypto space as a whole, but let me tell you something. I feel personally feel like we don't need regulation. That's just me. That's just how I feel. But I say that because the same people who we want to regulate the space that hasn't been regulated since its start, right? For the last 13, if not 14 years, we want these same people, the people that has been failing us year in and year out, to all of a sudden have our best interest at heart? No. No. If anything, they'll make it... They'll break the rules in a way to where it complements them, you know? But only way to find out is to basically watch it unfold, right? But I'll tell you this. Along this journey, we're going to see a lot. We're going to hear a lot, you know? And I want to be here to see it all. I want to see how this SEC case goes against Ripple. I want to see how this whole Reggie Middleton thing works out with his patents, Vertasium. I want to see how a lot of the coin, a lot of the John McAfee coins turn out as well. You know, DigiByte, Doge, what else? Verge, and so on. But I want to see it all, you know. I want to see me going into a store, right? And crypto being the standard, you know, I'm still having this problem to this day. Before the pandemic, you go in a store, they only accept cash or they only accept debit card, right? There's no, for the time, you know, there's no Cash App, there's no Venmo, you know, there's no Bitcoin, there's no crypto payments. I'm sick of it. But we shall overcome. We shall. I'm a firm believer in that. But in this space, back to what I was trying to get into, there's always going to be people that get in your way on your road to success, you know, on your road to freedom. Don't be discouraged. Keep a clear mind. Stay clear-headed. And, you know, try to block out all the FOMO, all the bullshit that comes your way. Just know this. The end game is always crypto. Always. Blockchain technology. We're not going backwards. We're going forwards. And, you know, know this as well. Self-custody is something that everybody needs to get acquainted with, right? It's not enough to just keep your coins and tokens on an exchange, right? Or in a hot wallet, right? Or in a mobile wallet. It's to self-custody them, you know, yourself. Self-custody them yourself. So therefore, you become the ultimate boss. You know what I'm saying? You can't name me one thing in this world today where the sense of privacy is at an all-time high, right? Let's just pretend you get a cold storage wallet, right? You write down your 12 to 24, you know, key phrase. And what do? You hide it. You don't tell anybody about it, but you hide it and you keep it a secret. You know, maybe you have multiple hiding spots around the city, you know, but the point is you can't name me not one thing in this world that tells you to do that. It doesn't happen with your social, doesn't happen with your ID, doesn't happen with your address, because a lot of these things are sitting in a folder somewhere at your job where anybody can get a hold of them, right? Crypto, self-custody is the only mechanism that we have that says, don't say nothing. You know what I'm saying? You could try to hide your stuff in a Swish, or what is it, like an overseas bank. If you got, you know, if you got juice like that, you could try to hide it in under your mattress, you know, under your bed, or wherever you think is a good hiding place. But self-custody is the way to go. There's a saying that's been going around since I've been in this thing. Not your keys, not your coins. Not your coins, not your key. But yeah. And I'm gonna end it there. I got nothing more to say, you know. Feel like I'm rambling at this point. But just know, man, every time you get discouraged, there's somebody out there going through it with you. That's me. I'm not where I wanna be in life as far as with this crypto thing. But I know exactly where I'm going. And it's been one hell of a ride, I tell you that. When it's all said and done, the people that got in early will be here to tell the story as to why and how and who and what caused them to do what they did as far as spreading the message around. You know, this crypto space, this early crypto space, it's early, but the YouTube part of it is even earlier, right? Because I know not everybody could do this. Not everybody has the courage, you know, the gall, the charisma to get on a camera once a week, every day, and talk about something that nobody hardly knows about, or at least pretends they don't know about, and, you know, believes in it. But I'm gonna end it there, man. Just know this. Buy as much as you can, if you want, for as little as you can. Why? Because you always won't be able to grab these coins and tokens at the current prices they are today. And remember, what you won't do, the next person will do. And just never forget where you come from, because where we're going, it will never be like this no more, you know? It won't be as easy as it once was before you acquired your fortune. See y'all next week. Peace.